Hello everyone, Empire here. Just wanted to talk about a little game I've just played, called Sable. So, during Christmas season, old Saint Epic bestowed upon the good gamer boys and girls 15 days of free games, which I abused. Kinda like 12 days of Christmas, but for games. And 15 days. Anywho, one of those free games was Sable. Sable is an exploration game taking place on an alien desert planet with an art style that is reminiscent? Inspired by the French artist Mobius. That's not his real name, but we'll just call him Mobius. We follow our little protag, Sable, as she starts her gliding. The gliding is a coming-to-age thing, like a quinceañera or a bar mitzvah, where she travels the lands to learn what she wants to do with her life. You travel the land, helping people, climbing things, exploring things, earning badges to get masks. You climb more things. You collect poop. Eh? And you also stumble upon like crashed spaceships that hold the secret history of the land. To help her travel, you get Bubble Boy powers with Featherfall qualities and a sand bike named Simoon. So, when I first started up Sable, the game kind of surprised me with a greeting of song. A really nice sounding song that was like a neutral aligned spirit singing to me. This led to a Googling session, finding out that a band called Japanese Breakfast did music for the game. They're not bad. Actually, after finding out who they were, I listened to some of their albums. They're nice. I like them. They're kind of like ethereal spirit music. You know, when you think of what ghosts would like, it would like this kind of music. Anyway, yeah. Japanese Breakfast did the soundtrack to the game, and it sounded good throughout the game. There's a range of sounding from otherworldly ambiance, echoing ship kind of sounds, and even some music that sounds straight out of Zelda. There are some vocal songs in the game, and they were sick, but there's only three. The main menu song, when you're exiting the starting area, the song called Gliding, and the credits song. I wish there was more. It's only those three vocal songs in the game. I really do wish there were more because the band sounds good, and the moment where you exit the starting area and hear the music, that was a good gaming moment. But what I didn't like was the credits song. The credits didn't even give the time for the song to finish. What was up with that? The song didn't have time to breathe, to sing, to me. Aw, the credits went so fast. I couldn't hear the whole music. But yeah, I wish there was more vocalized music from Japanese Breakfast in the game to emphasize bigger moments or discovery moments in the game. It would have put this game over the top for me. The game's style must have been influenced by the artist Mobius. It was actually recently that I found out about Mobius and began looking into his works, reading some of his comics, seeing what he inspired before Sable. You see, I found this old anime, I was looking around for old animes on YouTube for free, that was heavily inspired by him called Dragon's Heaven. Sick thing, it's only a 30 minute watch with a small documentary, them making life action things. Sick, recommended. It felt like I saw this whole sand world with future tech thing before, which led to me finding about Mobius. Now, I don't want to go too deep into this dude, but he had a super interesting life. Like, for example, he inspired Miyazaki's Nausicaa, became friends with Miyazaki. He even named his own child Nausicaa after the movie that he helped inspire. He worked on Tron, Fifth Element, Alien, Little Nemo, which is an old animated film that has a whole production nightmare history behind it. And you know what? Get this. Space Jam. That's right. He did character design for Space Jam. He worked on Space Jam. Not the new one, because he was dead before that one came out. I'm talking about the Michael Jordan Space Jam. The real Space Jam. And there's so much more to this guy that you can make several videos on. Like, he's French. Whoa. What I want to say is, at least to me, Mobius's work inspires like a world of wonder that feels like it has its own history beyond what is on the page, beyond what he's giving. He like used solid colors with little details in some panels in his pieces, while other artworks are just oozing with details and line works. Like, there is history, there is age, there's substance behind what we're seeing. Sable, I think, is trying to get the same feel that Mobius's art gives to me. The feel that you are in a world that is strange and alien to us, but it's absolutely normal to the inhabitants that are in it. It's just, you know, there's a giant worm on the planet, you know. It is what it is. Also, there's some obvious similarities between them. Alien desert planets, wearing strange clothes, weird alien creatures, spaceships, solid colors, and like lots of line works and images. I'm not saying it's a bad thing to copy or emulate a style. I personally think it's great to perpetuate a certain feel that another artist gives. I'm not saying this is a one-to-one copy or mimicry. I'm saying it is just what it is. It gives me the same feel as Mobius' works that some of the images Sable shows to me. I like it. I mean, yeah, go more of this. More sci-fi weird alien shit. Please, more. Please. The game doesn't have really much gameplay. Yeah. What I mean by that is there's only really climbing. Yeah. And I guess there is a fishing minigame thing, but it was whatever. I barely fished. I fished twice in the game in my 12 hours playing. And you get a fish to get the fishing mask. That's about it. Meh. As for the climbing, anyone that's played Breath of the Wild like me will draw a similarity between the Sable's climbing stamina system and Breath of the Wild's. But unlike Breath of the Wild, there's no leaps, tricks to the climbing. You can't like go faster or anything like that. It's you just climb. Just climb, climb, climb. Also, sometimes climbing in this game can be a little buggy. Yeah. Oh, there are these things called chooms in the game. I like the chooms. They have neat little animations after you nab one. I enjoy that. But it only has that one animation, so you better enjoy it every single time. The choom's purpose is to give the chooms to the choom queen to increase your stamina. That's how you increase your stamina. And that's it. That's it to the chooms. There's also no real sense of danger or threat in the game. You can't fall to your death. There's no enemies that can kill you except the worm. The game is just a chill exploration game. Look at the neat sights, neat images, strange landscapes. Even the quests in the game, I feel, really just push you to explore areas that are out of the way. Now, there are clothes and masks to collect in the game, but they are purely aesthetic. They don't offer any benefits, just whatever is your style. You might think the climbing clothes, for instance, will improve your climbing. Nah. No. However, the bike parts you can buy throughout the game do actually improve the bike. Though I do wish the color schemes for the bike were more dynamic or drastic. They're very dialed down to the point I can barely tell the color schemes apart. There's some interesting backstory to the game. To my understanding, the backstory is that the planet has some sort of electromagnetic field that causes ships to crash land, and that's what led to the current civilization, all these nomad tribes and cities on the planet. There's this thing called the Maw, which is a superstructure space station size of a planet that sent the Whale, which is a supermassive spaceship, to terraform this desert planet. All the ships on the planet originated from the Maw, and the people are descendants of all the astronauts, or terraformers, that crash landed here. You don't get to go to the Maw, or find out what is the cause of the electromagnetic field making the ships crash. No, that's whatever. That's not the point of the game. That's not why we're here. We're here to choose a job. To find the perfect mask for Sable, our future. And the perfect mask is the Whale / Atomic Mask. It's perfect. Look at it. Just beauty. This isn't really a review. Is this a review video? I mean, why did I make this video? This short little video. I enjoyed the game. Even though it has some bugs and faults and not much gameplay, I enjoy exploration games, looking at stuff, walking around. The music, I wish there was more music. And I just wanted somebody to talk to about it. Oh, and look at you. You're somebody. This game looked interesting. I don't know if many people even had this on their radar. I doubt that. There's so many games out there, and it's hard to keep up with everything, especially all these little indie games that are out about. And I found it, you know, serendipitous that I was just reading up and looking into this Mobius guy, and boom, there's a game that I just got for free that looked like his style. It was as though the fates were working in my favor. But yeah, if you want to try this game, or if you missed out on getting it free from Epic, I would definitely suggest waiting for a sale. Because its current price is $25, and for what it is, unless you really dig exploration games like me, I would definitely wait. Because it's mainly a collectathon, explorathon, as I've said several times already. And nowadays, we have to save our money, right guys and gals? We gotta save our money to buy eggs. Eggs are so freaking expensive right now. They're so pricey. They were my protein source. I need to find a new protein source because they're too pricey. $5 or more for eggs? No. I say no, sir. Or ma'am. Also, if you want to watch me just playing the game, enjoying hours of boredom, I'm sure you'll have, of me going through it, I made a second channel to keep things more organized and kind of separate from long, unedited content versus stuff I want to do more of. And so I'm sure there's a link in the description below for that, or if I figure out how to put in the thing here. Yeah, it's like Empire the Whole Pie. If you want to check it out, go ahead. If not, totally understandable. So thanks for watching. Bye-bye. And you know, man, I really would have liked more moments like when you left the starting area and hear that hopefully not DMCA-able music. That was a sick feeling. Come in.
tell.